Well, the house fire at 15 Dogwood Lane in Glen Carbon. Our emergency response teams, along with the fire department, responded to the house fire immediately.
Okay. Who was in? Was it 7 kids inside?
Number of children, we believe, is 6.
Okay.
All children were able to exit the house safely, and they actually called 911 and reported it.
Okay. Did they go to the Walmart to call 911?
2 of the children did, yes.
Okay. And is this in connection that, obviously you said 6 people or 6 kids, that 7th, is that connected to that situation near Highland?
That is unknown at this time. It's an ongoing investigation. We have not confirmed that.
Okay. Are the children related?
The children are related to one another. They're all siblings.
Okay. Do we know, as far as what led up to this? I mean, is this fire suspicious? What happened?
We do not have specifics on that at this time. All we know is there was a house fire. We do not know what the cause of it was. We do know that all the children got out safely, and our hearts and our thoughts and our prayers go out to the entire family for their terrible loss. And we're providing all the resources we possibly can to the family to ensure that they're going to be taken care of.
How old were these children?
The children, they range from teenage down to infancy.
Okay.
You said we have a fatality. Is there? I might not have caught that. So is there a fatality on the scene?
I can confirm that there was 1 fatality. It was an adult. We do not know the age and or gender at this time.
Do you know if the children lived at the home? Is that their house or were they?
Yes,
staying?
They do live there.
Okay.
Have you had any prior run-ins with this family at all?
We have been out to the residence in the past.
Okay. Multiple times, a couple of times?
Several times.
Okay.
However, it's just normal day-to-day calls.
Do you know if it was a parent who died or was it?
We do not know this time.
Okay.
Do you have anybody in custody in relation to this at all?
No, it's an ongoing investigation.
Okay. And then the deceit is that we don't know it. There's 1 parent. Do we have the whereabouts of the other parent of the children? Do we have the mom, dad, or?
We do not know who the decedent was. And at this point in time, we just know that the children are safe.
Is it a male or female, though?
We do not know. No.
So are you looking for somebody, the other parent, at this point?
At this point in time, it's an ongoing investigation where we're just trying to make sure everybody who was at that residence is safe.
How are the kids doing physically and mentally?
They're with family members at this time. They are receiving emotional support, and we're providing everything that we can to the entire family to make sure that they're going to be taken care of.
Any reason to believe these kids saw something that they should not have?
We do not have any information on that.
Okay.
What's happening at the scene now?
We're just ensuring that the scene is kept safe at this point in time, and we're investigating it as we would any other fire.
Can you at least tell me that you all are looking to see if the 2 scenes are connected near Highland and then this one?
Is that a possibility at all? It is a possibility. However, at this point in time, it's just an ongoing investigation where we're dealing with the facts as they come in, and only the facts.
Is it hard to deal with a case like this when it involves so many children?
It's a terrible tragedy. Anytime children are involved, it makes it even more difficult. Anytime there's loss of life, it's heartbreaking. And this is one of those times that, as a community, we will come together. We will provide all the support we possibly can for the family to ensure that the kids, the adults, and everybody involved are taken care of.